Dito Telecommunications accuses its rival telcos Globe and Smart of creating a ruse to prevent interconnection. The third major telco player earlier filed abuse of dominant position complaints against Globe and Smart with the Philippine Competition Commission for supposedly barring most calls from Dito subscribers. In response, Globe said Dito should instead pay a fine of 622 million pesos for interconnection penalties and failure to address fraudulent calls that are using its network. Smart has also called out Dito over this issue.
I'm really quite surprised why they're saying that, oh, the reason we filed these cases is because we can't pay them these ISR charges. It's actually quite laughable because, number one, they, by that admission, they're already saying that our complaint is valid because they are making interconnection, which is mandated by law, subject to our acceptance and payment as a condition for them to interconnect with us. Out of 100 calls, the average calls from Dito that can get through to a Smart or Globe line is only maybe 20 calls out of 100. Now, the grade of service, this is what is mandated by law and the NTC, out of 100 calls, 99 should get through. But when Smart and Globe call Dito, their calls get through because we adhere to the grade of service as mandated by the NTC.
Meanwhile, Tamano clarifies fraudulent calls made by global criminal syndicates have long been a problem of the telco industry. He says they've put up cybersecurity systems to prevent such calls. Philippine Senator Raffy Tulfo wants a probe into continuing power outages in the provincial, make that in the province of Oriental Mindoro. And as Alvin El Chico tells us, the Energy Department is citing supply issues as one of the causes of the problem.
Brownout na naman dito sa Mindoro.
Francis Nahito is one of the residents of Oriental Mindoro who complain about the intermittent supply of electricity in the province. While power supply is back, businesses and residents are complaining about the effects of frequent power fluctuations.
Kung may function po, halimbawa brownout, tapos naando na kami sa mismong event, tapos walang kuryente, hindi po magagamit si lights and sounds. Halimbawa po, may kasal, so hindi na po magagamit yung lights and sounds. Ang mangyayari po doon, ako po mismo mag-shoulder ng generator. Sana ayusin po ang serbisyo ng Ormeco. Dahil nagbabayad naman po ng tama ang mga taga Mindoro eh. Pagka po hindi nakabayad ng tama, puputulan agad nila. Nasaan po yung hustisya?
Senate Energy Chairperson Raffy Tulfo is initiating a formal probe into the issue that will seek answers from officials of the Energy Department, Energy Regulatory Commission, cooperatives, and other energy players. Tulfo says the situation in several provinces, including Oriental Mindoro, is unacceptable.
Anong klaseng company ka? Nagpataas ka ng sweldo. Dapat magandang, naging magandang performance at tumaas yung revenue because of the good performance. In this case, saan nila kinuha yung pambigay ng bonus? Samantalang bad naman performance, alam ko na. Kasi nga, naniningit sila ng sobra-sobra, sino-shortchange nila ang kanilang mga consumer.
Energy Secretary Rafael Utilia is ready to face the Senate, but he says there are no shortcuts in finding a solution, especially that NAPUCOR, the agency in charge of missionary electrification, has already run out of funds.
The President is not after band-aid solutions. We have to go for long-term solutions. The amount of subsidy has been inadequate, and therefore the National Power Corporation has run out of funds. And we have to admit that there is such a problem, and therefore the Energy Regulatory Commission in its part is running full speed in order to be able to help alleviate that.
Lutilia admits the Philippines is energy insecure as its overall sources of energy come from imported and more expensive fossil fuel, especially in off-grid areas.
The total supply of energy that we are using is 56.8% imported, as against only 43% domestic or indigenous. So, you can say that we are very energy insecure,
okay.
Less than 50%.
Aside from pushing for more renewable energy, Lotilia says the Philippines is open to try using nuclear power, particularly the modular type.
We will attend to them when they become commercially available. But right now, we will focus instead on one, for example, establishing the regulatory framework.
Lotilia clarifies, though, that on the issue of the revival of the Bataan Nuclear Power Plant, any decision should be consulted first with the community surrounding it as well as the local government. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.